As early as the 6th century BCE, the first cataract surgery is said to have been performed by the ancient Indian physician Sushruta. Sushruta was the most celebrated physician and surgeon in India. Many of his contributions to medicine and surgery preceded similar discoveries in the Western world. Sushruta devotes a complete volume of his experiences to ophthalmologic diseases. In the Uttara Tantram, Sushruta enumerates a sophisticated classification of eye diseases, complete with signs, symptoms, prognosis, and medical or surgical interventions. In particular, Sushruta describes what may have been the first extracapsular cataract surgery, using a sharply pointed instrument, with a handle fashioned into a trough. The patient was asked to sit on a high stool, with the surgeon sitting in front of him face to face. He was instructed to look at the surgeon's nose while the operator placed the tip of his little finger on the bony margin of the outer angle of the orbit, holding a sharp, pointed needle between his thumb, index, and middle finger. The point entered the anterior chamber, at the junction of the medial and lateral two-thirds of the outer portion of the white layer, sclera, of the eyeball. If a sound was produced followed by the gushing of watery fluid, then the surgeon's needle was considered to be in the correct part of the eyeball, but if this puncture was followed by bleeding, it meant that it was misplaced. Care was taken to avoid blood vessels present in that region. The tip of the needle was then made to incise the capsule of the lens. With the needle in this position, the patient was asked to blow down the nostril, while closing the opposite nares. After this procedure, according to Sushruta, lens material came out alongside the needle, and when the patient was able to perceive objects, the needle was removed. To remove the cataract from the eyes, he used a curved needle to loosen the lens and push the cataract out of the field of vision. The eye would then be bandaged for a few days till it healed completely. Sushruta's surgical works were later translated to Arabic language, and through the Arabs, his works were introduced to the West. For more such stories, don't forget to click on the bell icon and subscribe to the Green YouTube channel. Also, remember to like and share our videos.